Okay. Day one, Gary is just leaving. We've heard it's just getting dark here. Oh, hold on. Let me, so I just got here this afternoon. I'm, northwest of Shoe Lake. It is 6:18 p.m., 6:20 p.m. So we've laid out some apples. This steelhead are running big time right now. And I know you can't see anything, so hold on. Let me just shine a light out just so you get an idea of where I am. Hold on. So, yeah, I've got apples out there. So we've heard monkey howls right before Gary left, and Gary's convinced that they know my voice. So here's where I am. And the steelhead are running big time right now. So we're going to see what happens. It's still pretty early, but like I say, we've already heard monkey howls, coming from the hillside, right in front of the camera. And I expect some activity tonight, but we'll see what happens. Here I am. I'm back up here, and we'll see what happens. Apples are on the post right out there in front of the van. You can't see them now, but we're going to see if they're going to come in. Oh, man, I thought I saw some movement. But yeah, we heard howls big time just a little while ago. From three different locations, and I got a real eerie feeling right now, so I'm gonna monitor it. This is just an intro. I'm gonna monitor this, kind of take it easy and see what happens, man. All right, guys, love you. Okay, this is day two. I said I wasn't going to do locations, and well, you know, I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'm at the Daphne campground, which is 15 miles south of Powers. It's way deep in the forest, but it is they have a resident campground host here, who's a good friend. Well, he's a friend of mine, Billy Bob. And so anyways, why I came here is, so my theory at this point right now is to go to where the food is. So right now the steelhead are running big time in the river, and you can hear the river behind me. I'm pointed at it. Anyways, it's a huge run right now. I mean, there's a lot of fish in that river. So I went up and down the river today. I checked a couple different spots where I could camp at, and about the only good spot is, believe it or not, is here. There's Island Campground, which is up a mile or two up the road, south of here, up the 33 road. And I'm gonna go there tomorrow. And then there's actually a spot on the side of the road. See, I'm trying to get where the food is, so I'm trying to get as close to the Coquille River as I can, and then find these spots where I think a Bigfoot would hunt for fish. So, all right. So I've got a question here for you guys. All right, when I was at Larson during a steelhead run, I get the strong scent of fish up there. And I don't think it was just from their fur or whatever. I mean, it very well could have possibly been. But my question is this, and I'm really hoping to get some good feedback on this or a good theory, but what if they're carrying fish back to their nesting spot? And then, well, and then it gets to the point of how are they storing the fish? And then I just have no idea. So anyways, so now we're on the theory. All right, so we've got a big primate who needs a lot of animals, a lot of food to exist. And of all the Bigfoots I've seen, they're not skinny. So, you know, how are they doing it? So we have, the reason I'm asking that is there's only limited steelhead run. So then I got to thinking, okay, so if I'm, and I'm a big guy, all right, I'm 6'6", and I could easily live in these woods. And how I would do it is just what I've theorized. First of all, we get the steelhead, I'd go there, but the steelhead run limited time. So then when the steelhead aren't running, then I would go for mushrooms. All right, mushrooms are everywhere. You get those, but then that again is on a limited time, you know, because, you know, you just can't find them all the time. So then we got frogs. Frogs are the big, all right, and I'm talking about this area right here where it's not freezing. And the people like I was talking to Gary last night, and Gary's, oh man, it took a lot of frogs to do that. There's a movie, and it's based on a true story from Alaska, and maybe some of you guys know about this, but it's about a guy who was researching wolves, and he went up there and set up a tent, and if one of you guys remember the movie, or you know, maybe you can quote the name of the movie, but anyways, he sat in a tent and he ended up living off of mice that were going into his tent, and he lived off the same diet as a wolf, and so these wolves were living off these mice, and people didn't believe it, but you know, it's actually been proven since then, you know, that's the case. So anyways, what I'm saying is, like, okay, so if I'm hungry, and I'm talking about me, a big guy, and I'm in the woods, and dude, I'm gonna go for frogs. You know, they're everywhere, and so if I find a swamp that has a whole bunch of frogs, I'm gonna go in there and hunt them. You know, if any of you guys who lived in like really rural areas, and you remember catching frogs with your kids, I mean, just think back to that. Even the frog eggs and just going in there and catching frogs, man, I remember that. But if it was a matter of survival, I mean, all right, so I'm talking about when I was a kid. You know, we'd go in there and catch frogs and get frog eggs and tadpoles and all kinds of stuff. But if it's a matter of survival, I could easily live off, if I had to be in these woods and live without anything else, I would definitely do that. So anyways, that's my point. So frogs. So that's what brings me here. We got the steelhead run happening right now. You hear the river running behind me, and it's right just a couple feet below the van, and that's why I'm here. We're going to see what happens. The apples, I don't know if you can see that, there's one left. They never grab those, but let me zoom in. Yeah, so I got one apple right there. And I have four or five on post. I was camped at a different spot last night when Gary left. But the other ones were left on rocks in the background there that were taken the last time I was up here. And that wasn't during the steelhead run. So last night we heard howls, monkey whoops, and howls. I talked to Billy Bob today. I was able to catch him, and he told me, he heard sounds at about he estimated from 12:30 p.m. or 12:30 a.m. just after midnight to about 2 o'clock in the morning. And that's the same thing I heard. So last night I didn't do anything interactive. I just observed, and I was hoping they'd catch the apples. They didn't get the apples, but I've heard a lot of activity. And it is, hold on, let me check. It is, excuse me for not being more prepared. So it is 5:40 right now. 5:40, it's fixing to get dark, and we're gonna see what happens. Gary ended up mentioning when he was standing by the van, he said, you know, they know your voice. So man, I don't know. So the only reason I'm here, and I don't like being in well, this is one of the nicest campgrounds in this forest here. I don't like being here, but man, we're getting a lot of activity, and right now, that's it. So I'm gonna spend another day here, and then tomorrow I'm gonna head, well, depending on what happens tonight, I'm gonna head to a spot next to the river, probably just off the road. And I will keep you guys posted, but we'll see what happens tonight, man. I really, they were definitely around last night, man. I could hear them all over. So yeah, remember this view because I'm going to record when it gets dark. Oh, and when I was here before, I had eyeshine from over, roughly over that area. I don't know if you can check out the video where we were feeding apples to Bigfoot, where they actually took them. But anyway, so I'm going to look for eyeshine. Well, I think they're really going to be going for the steelhead. That's it. So, all right. And another thing is, this expedition, this one right here, which is last a few weeks, is dedicated to my grandson Sam. I guess he's interested in Bigfoot. I haven't spoken to him. But I talked to my daughter Chloe, and I guess he's really into Bigfoot. And so I'm dedicating this expedition to Sam. I love you, and I think that, you know, you being a part of this right now, in spirit, that we're gonna find something this time. So yeah, that's the plan. So we're starting. We're gonna go where the food is, and see what happens. So yeah, this looks like a really developed campground, and it's way really deep in the forest. Anyone who knows this area knows exactly what I'm talking about. You get in the middle of the forest, and boom, here's this really nice campground. Billy Bob, a great guy. So if you ever make it to Daphne, introduce yourself to Billy Bob. And Billy Bob's a great guy. And he's the host up here. And he's a Forest Service employee. And I also want to talk, when I touched base with him today, which is great, we were talking about Shoe Lake, you know, which is just up the road from here. He was telling me, man, I can't even, he says, I can't go up there, and the place just creeps me out. he said he had to, they had a job up at Butt Creek, which is just up the road from True Lake. And he said on the way back, he said, yeah, I'm going to go check out True Lake. So he went in there patrol, and he said, man, I was out of there right away. So they creeped him out. And then I said, yeah, you know, he does the same to me. So even Forest Service employees are creeped out from Shoe Lake, of Shoe Lake. I'm going to definitely make it up there within, well, weather permitting, within the next, within a week. Like I say, I'm going to be up there for a few weeks. So we're going to see what happens tonight. Love you guys. Love you, Sam. Love you, Chloe. Yeah, man. We'll see what happens tonight. Danny out. Alright, so I'm heading up to Shoe Lake. And it's, I don't know what to expect. So one thing I want to talk about is fear. Is facing your fears. Alright, here we go. Yeah. And we're going to see what happens. But yeah, you know, you have to face your fears in anything in life. Maybe I'll talk to my grandson right now, or actually to anybody. You know, there's healthy fears. Which, you know, you don't want to get wow, this road is really rough right now. But yeah, this is even the Forest Service staff up here. This is a spooky spot for them, and I'm going in, man. I have to do it. Yeah, so you have to face your fears. Like, what's the worst that can happen? And, you know, I'm not condoning, you know, going in, you know, balls to the walls, you know, whatever, but sometimes in life you have to face your fears. So hold on. I'm gonna play some music. Alright, here we go. But yeah, I've been really, really scared of this area. Hold on. Alright, gotta turn that radio off. Anyways, so I've been really, 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 really scared of this area. Shit. Anyways. But I'm facing my fears, man. You know, like, you guys have got it where they've slapped the side of the van. And I'm not going into that far-off spot. Yeah, but we're going into True Lake right now. What I'm gonna do
Well, I've hold on. So I've dedicated this to my grandson Sam, and yeah, so that's what I'm doing. I'm gonna tell you, it is spooky. And we're gonna see what happens. Yeah, even the locals, they're like saying, I'm nuts if I go up here. Alright, here we go. Here we go, man. All right, I'll tune in here in a few.
All right, it's 7:35. I've gotten this shoe. Like, what is remarkable is I'm smelling a big fishy smell, well, which would be steelhead. And yeah, this is really remarkable. Well, because there's no other than trout in these yeah, so I just got here. And yeah, I'm like smelling a, and then what I asked about earlier is if they're taking salmon, how could they store it? All right. They're here. I know it, man. Yeah, the minute I got here, so I had to get, I parked the van. I'm not in the parking spot up the hill. I'm down in the lower area. But man, I smelled that really strong fish smell. Now, like I say, it's not even 8 p.m., man. So I'm gonna go to town tonight. Tyler Hayes, man, and I love you, Tyler. He was talking about that, and he caught this. Not many people do, if you're not in this area, but there's a unnamed lake, and that's where I believe their nesting area is. And Tyler, don't go there. Oh, shit. So yeah, I'm up at True Lake, man. And I'm going to tell you. So I was talking about fear on my way up here, and you just have to, sometimes in your life, you have to face your fears, man. Like earlier today, I talked to a Forest Service employee who's worked here. All right, I'm getting a strong fish scent right now. So they're either carrying fish through or fish is on them. Yeah, they're up here, man. Anyways, about the fear, if you're going to be looking for Bigfoot, you have to overcome that fear, but it has to be a healthy fear. You know, like, you don't want to be like, you know, a dumb shit who goes and does stupid crap, man. You know, you just have to face those fears. Like, all right, so what scares me most about this spot is that the size of that Bigfoot I saw up here, it was huge. And I mean, it could just squash my van if it wanted to. I mean, literally. Here's where I get into logics. So it hasn't done that kind of thing. You know, we don't have a big Bigfoot squashing vans or anything like that. And I think these guys know me. Gary kind of stressed that yesterday. He says, I think they know your voice, man. And so that's why I'm here. But don't get me wrong. I am, you know, facing fear. I'm very scared up here. You know, when we were up here before, we were surrounded. And right now, I'm not only getting the scent of a fish, which would not be any, you know, it had to be imported from down below. But not only that, but I'm getting sounds out there in the woods. And not only that, that sixth sense, man. So, yeah, we're here. Yeah, they're there. So anyways, I just got here. I'm going to kind of get my camp set up, which is my van. And then I'm going to probably play some music. I'm going to try to attract him in. Maybe we won't even need that, but yeah, I love you guys. Bye. All right. So it is. Damn it. Just for 8 p.m. Not getting any scents like it did, but what I'm going to try to do is they're out there. I'm gonna start playing some music and let me try a couple whistles. couple more. I'm not getting the strong scent like I did earlier. I'm not getting anything as far as scents go. Not hearing anything. So I'm gonna blast some music, man. I'm gonna go to town and then see what happens. If you know, Gary was saying, right, they know me, they know my voice. And I've got the shotgun mic attached to the camera. Anyways, I'm going to play some music. I'm just going to, you know, go for town and then I'll touch base with you guys in a few. It is 1952, 1752, right before 8 p.m. Love you guys. Bye. So it's 8:20 p.m. at Shrew Lake. I've been playing Native American music. I haven't got that strong fish scent that I initially got when I first showed up here. I'm being quiet because I'm hoping I've got the shotgun mic attached to the camera right now. Let me try a couple whistles. Try a couple more. Hello? So, Gary mentioned that they may know my voice, and you know, that combined with the van, you know, the me being, I don't know, man, but anyways, I'm hoping they'll know I'm not a threat. But yeah, coming up here. Definitely facing fears. No doubt about that. Not hearing anything, not... You know, these guys are so intelligent, man. All right. I'm hearing something, some movement out there. All right. So we're going to, I'm going to continue to play some music and just kind of, we'll see what happens, man. Hey, 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 hey Right there, out there. Hello? Hello? There's something moving out there. Hello? Hello? You guys out there? All right. It's Danny. Hello? Man. Come and talk to me, man. Hello? Hello? I'm gonna go ahead and try the Sierra Sounds, and man, I really don't want to do that, but all right, here we go. Hello? Hello? I got one whistle back. Hello? Hello?
Okay, I'll go back here.
Continue to play music. I'm getting a sense of them. Nothing really strong though.
You guys getting that scent? Or that whistle? It's got a whistle. Hello? They're right there. You know, this group, they're not scared of nothing, man. So I've, yeah, we'll see what happens. I'm going to play some more music. Man. Hello? It's midnight, well, 9 minutes before midnight, at Shrew Lake. And I just heard some, heard some sounds on the other side of the hill there. I was playing some music, got the shotgun mic attached so you guys could hear better than I can. So here we go. I'm gonna try a couple whistles. Hello? Alright, I know they know my van. I know they know my voice. Well, they know me. And I'm kind of hoping for some good interaction here. I've been playing music off and on here this evening. So no one comes up here because it's creepy. And even the Forest Service employees I've talked to, man, they don't like coming up here. Really still right now. Man, but I hope I get something tonight. Like before, you know, a couple years ago or a year ago, and you can check my past videos I've had, where I've had those monkey whoops or, you know, howls I've captured. But tonight, well, what's really interesting is when I first showed up here, I had that really strong fish scent, and then nothing. Like, I'm not getting anything right now. But when I first showed up here, man, it was kind of alive.
See, I'm going to play some more music and then see what happens. But I think a lot of people are surprised, even me, that I even showed up here tonight. I was talking to Gary. Gary said, hey, yeah, you need to talk to, you know, there's a bunch of people in Powers that want to talk to me. I talked to Billy Bob. Hold on, get something. Hello? Getting something out there, man. You know, and everyone avoids this spot right here. They're like, yeah, no, we're not going up there. And you're nuts to go up there. And that's why I was like, well, you know, I was sitting there at Daphne earlier tonight. I was like, well, you know what? I'm going to do this. If nothing else for my grandson, Sam. Because this is what I've been doing, man. Is proving these guys are, real. All right, so I'm going to play some music, and then I'm going to keep the door open just like this, but I'm going to tell you this right now, that I'm backed up, and that tells you I'm getting some kind of, you know, that not scared, but aware of what's happening here tonight. All right, so I'm going to get back with you guys in a few. Love you. Bye. All right. It's about 12:30 at night at True Lake. And I'm getting a strong scent right now. Hey, let me try a couple. Hold on. Try a couple of whistles. They're out there, right there. Hold on. Hello? Hello? Man, I'm telling you, it gets so discouraging. Let me try a couple whoops. Whoop! Whoop! Man, I don't get it. All right, so they know my van, and even Gary, you know, said they know my voice, so they know me, and I just don't get why they. Hello? Are you out there? It's Danny. Yeah, it's starting to get really cold right now, so I think I'm gonna shut it down. But yeah, man, I've been trying, man. All right, man, I'm gonna shut the van door. I got some food if you want it, although I think you've got fish. Are you there? Hello? So even when they try to sneak up, you know, you'll hear a branch snap here and there. And I'm not getting that at all. I'm not getting any scent at all either. Although when I first pulled up, man, it had a really strong scent. So, they're definitely not the alpha in the woods. So humans are, you know, or the alpha. Anyways, that's my theory. All right, so I'm gonna call it a night unless anything happens after this. Hello? Yeah, but I'm up a sure lake, man. We'll see what happens. And it is just after midnight, so still got the night to go through. So, all right. I love you guys. Bye. Okay. It's about 4:08, 4:10. And I've got something outside the van. Real putrid smell, man. Excuse me, I just got up. Ugh.
So I've got something outside though. Yeah, the scent is, it's pretty bad. I don't want to open anything yet. All right. Hold on, man.
Okay, it's 4:30. At True Lake, in the parking area next to the lake, need to charge my solar panels, so that's why I'm not in that back area. I got here last night. I woke up at 4. I don't know why, man, but it was a real putrid smell from outside the van. So I stayed up for a few hours. I heard some noises. But nothing significant. I heard some branch breaking. I thought I heard a whistle. I don't know. I've got to review my footage from last night. But so I actually just got up, man. I was up, I went to sleep for an hour or two, and then at 4 o'clock I woke it up, and then stayed up until I don't know, 9 or 10 a.m. and then went to sleep, and then I woke up a couple of times. So I've got the shotgun mic attached. I'm hearing some noises. Now I'm getting some scent right now, that same putrid scent. Not as strong as I did at 4. But I believe I heard some monkey howls. I don't know, like I say, the shotgun mic is attached. You'll hear better than I will. So I played some music last night. Kind of announced that I was here. And it's always been, you know, night two is when something happens, so I expect some activity tonight. I don't know what. This place has always been live, so we'll see what happens. This is my first night here alone. I was here with Tom, but this is the first time alone since that experience me and Gary had, and I'm at the exact location where it happened in the parking area by the lake. Like I said, the steelhead are running. Some whistles. know if it's, it could just be birds. I don't know. Okay, so remember this view. Getting that real strong feeling of being watched. And notice how quiet it is. All right, I'm gonna maybe something to eat and wake up. Let's say just after 4:30, it'll be dark in a couple hours. So, all right, Danny out. All right, it's 10:20 at night. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm at Daphne. I got here last night from Shoe Lake, but there's a camper. So that's where I usually, where I was camped before, where I saw the ice shine and where we had fed some Bigfoot, but we've got a camper down there. He's lit up the whole campground. And earlier tonight, I heard whistles, and it was strange. It sounded like they were whistling to each other right after it got dark, like calling each other in or something. I don't know, but kind of wondering what's happening. I heard some sounds earlier. I thought it was somebody else coming in, but yeah, I don't know what's going on, man. I don't know if you can see that at all. This is lit up big time right now. Oh, shit. Damn it. Whoa. Yeah, it's kind of spooky right now. Yeah. Very, very spooky. I don't have my mouth on or shotgun mic. This is just very strange. Excuse the language. Yeah, so I saw it. They got a really nice camper, like a Class B, an older man. Yeah, that's lit up in the area where I saw that ice shine the one time. And I was camped the other way where my headlights were the other way. Otherwise, I would have done what he's doing. But I did spotlight that area. That's on YouTube also. Where I'm feeding the apples, the Bigfoot video. But he's parked exactly where I was. Yeah, I don't know what's going on, man. And maybe it's nothing. But yeah, I did hear activity earlier this evening. Whistles. And it's really creepy here. Yeah, this campground is way in the middle of the mountains. I'm gonna say, like, I think 15 miles south of Powers. I mean, it's a really nice campground, but it's in the middle of nowhere. Right on the Coquille River. And the fish are running right now. My whole theory of
you know, Bigfoot going. And I really think that's what they were doing earlier this evening. Like maybe one clan calling to another, whistling to each other that they're starting fishing or something. I don't know. But I saw Gary stop by earlier today, and he said, yeah, I asked him if the fish were running. He says, yeah, man. He shined a light in the river, and he says, man, there are fish everywhere. So we're definitely where the food are right now. I'm really wondering why these people are doing this. I don't see anything. Man, you really can't see anything either, can you? Yeah. So anyways, I'm going to continue to watch this. I'm wondering what they're, you know, why they've got their lighting up the campground there. So I'll keep my eyes peeled. Like I say, it was 10:20 when I started this video, and we'll see what happens.